Welcome to the Northwood News. My name is Kel. Tuesday, December 17, day 3. It's Samosa Day. No pizza, that's right. No pizza. Buy your samosa and support your school. Friday, December 20th, day 1. It's Pajamas Day. Wear your pajamas to school for that day. Remember to always choose kind.
The good word is we learn something new every day.
What's the good word?
The good word is
that we had a great assembly tonight.
I love to go to school and dancing.
Would you get my back? Would you take my call when I start to crack? Would you rescue me?
How the girls Viola doing?
We've done great. We did a great job and a lot of teamwork, I guess.
Sadly, the team came to an end.
Yeah.
For all the teams. Have a good time.
Comment ça va?
Ça va bien. Merci à toi.
Ça va bien. This means, hi, how are you?
Good.
And I said, I'm good too.
Talk much, not anymore. Broken bottles, slamming doors, but we still care about
addition. In particular, we'll be exploring addition structures or types of addition, as well as properties of addition. Let's get started. Now, with addition, we have two structures or ways we can think of addition scenarios. The first is pretty typical. Suppose there are three chicks eating. Then, four more chicks come to eat as well. How many chicks are there all together? Now, this is a pretty common scenario, and it has a name. We call this a joining addition problem, and some even call it active addition, since some action took place here with the second set or group of chicks that came into the scene after. Now, let's look at another addition structure. Here, we have Landon, who has four loonies, and Talia, who has five loonies. The question is, how many loonies do they have all together? For you and I, it's likely that we don't see this type of addition differently than the first. However, there is a slight nuance, and that is the fact that there was no action. Here, we're given two parts, and we're hoping to find the whole. We call this part-part-whole addition, or passive addition. Something worth noticing is that both addition structures, joining or active addition, and part-part-whole, or what we call passive addition, look pretty similar when we model with the visuals on the screen. So it's probably not necessary for our students or our children to be able to identify the structures of addition, but we do want to ensure that they can recognize both types of scenarios are in fact addition. Now, let's look at a really important number property that applies to addition, regardless of the structure. I'm sure you'd agree that 4 loonies plus 5 loonies is equivalent to 5 loonies plus 4 loonies, right? Well, our ability to move or swap the addends in an addition scenario is known as the commutative property. Now, the name sounds pretty scary, but think of the word commute. Some of us commute to work each day, or commute to the soccer field. Well, in addition, the addends can commute. Just like the 4 loonies and 5 loonies in this problem can commute. And the result is the same quantity of 9 loonies. And the same is true when we have more than 2 addends, or 2 parts. For example, if we add Kiera, who has 2 loonies, we can commute the quantities of 4 loonies, 5 loonies, and 2 loonies in any order, and will still result in the same quantity of 11 loonies. 2 more loonies than we had originally with Talia and Landon alone.
Please stand for the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, Canada, our home.
Would you rescue me? Would you get my back? Would you take my call when I start to crack? Would you rescue me? Would you rescue me?